Okay, this is just a quick video that will go through the process of creating your note cards. And your note cards will be where you keep all of your notes for your research paper. The idea behind having the note cards is that number one, you should do all of your research beforehand and then sit down to type your paper using both your outline and your research. The idea is not that you are trying to type your paper while you have 10 extra tabs open, trying to go back and forth between informational websites and your paper. You do all of that research on the front end, and this is how we keep it organized and usable. The first type of note card that you will have will be a source card. As you can see on your screen, source cards have the type of source at the top. In this case, it is for a book. And then below, it has the full MLA citation, including the hanging indent. Now, it's absolutely fine for you to go to BibMe or Citation Machine or whatever other application you use and put your source information in to that to generate your MLA citation. But you then have to go back to your source card and handwrite that MLA citation like you see here. Because you are required to have a minimum of 8 sources in your group of 32 note cards, you will have at least 8 types of, or excuse me, 8 of these card types, 8 source types or source cards in total. The second type of card you will have are notes cards, which are notes from your sources. Notes will have each card will have 4 or 5 notes from your source. You'll see the example here of the types of notes you should be taking and how you can also write that information on your note card. Those source note cards are arranged behind their source card, so everything is organized. So you will know once you come to a source card, all of the notes cards behind that will have information from that particular source. You will have a minimum of 24 of these types of cards, which means you have at least 4 note cards with notes on them per each one of your sources. And that gets you to the 32 count. Do not number your cards because in some cases you may need to go back and take additional notes from a source, and you will have to be able to put those notes behind the other cards in that source section. I do have an example of how your cards should look at my desk. So if you have questions, you can come back and take a look at that. Remember, your first group of cards, I believe 16 of cards, is due by Wednesday, November 4th.